In this video, we're going to talk about the top 10 anti-inflammatory foods. So before starting this video, please leave us a like and subscribe to the channel for our future updates. Number 10. Almonds. Among the many nutrients found in almonds are monounsaturated, healthy fats, vitamin E, and manganese. Also high in magnesium and plant protein, they're a good source of energy. Almond consumption has been linked to a lower risk of heart disease in studies connected to date. Their effects on the balance of fatty acids in your blood may be beneficial to your overall health. It has been shown that almonds might make you feel full. They have a greater calorie count than other anti-inflammatory foods, but taking a few of them daily may help you keep to a balanced weight loss plan more successfully. Number 9. Avocados. The heart-healthy lipids in avocados make them a delicious snack. Aside from that, they're a rich source of magnesium as well as fiber and potassium. Adding half of an avocado to your daily vitamin C, A, E, and B complex vitamins intake is a great way to increase your intake of these nutrients. They also have a reduced salt content as an added advantage. Avocados also contain polyphenols, which are antioxidants that protect the body against free radical damage. Secondly, antioxidants protect your body from cell damage. Avocado slices can be used to dress up a sandwich or salad, or they can be used to produce a delicious guacamole sauce. Avocados are packed with heart-protective monounsaturated fatty acids that assist to keep our heart healthy. They're also a good source of fiber. One half of an avocado provides roughly 7 grams of the 25 to 38 grams of fiber per day that are suggested for women and men respectively. Adding more fiber to your diet is one of the most straightforward things you can do to eat in an anti-inflammatory manner and prevent disease, according to Ferguson. For starters, fiber makes it simpler to lose weight and maintain a healthy weight, which in turn helps to reduce the risk of weight-related inflammation. Additionally, fiber is essential in maintaining a happy and healthy gut flora, which we now understand plays a vital role in the development of chronic diseases. Number 8. Broccoli. Broccoli is a type of vegetable that belongs to the cerciferous family, heavily concentrated in glucosinolates, which are a phytochemical. Phytochemicals are antioxidants that are derived from plant sources. Also high in vitamin C, potassium, calcium, and vitamin A. Broccoli is a low-calorie food that provides a lot of nutrition without adding much fat. Putting extra broccoli in your diet is simple because it's tasty either cooked or raw. The consumption of cerciferous vegetables such as broccoli have been associated to a lower risk of developing some cancers, according to research. Number 7. Blueberries. There are several polyphenols in blueberries. Cancer and heart disease may be prevented if you consume foods that stimulate antioxidant activity in your body. They are made up of plant-based compounds such as flavonoids, anthocyanins, phenolic acid, and tannins, which work together to prevent and heal cell damage. The compounds found in blueberries, according to laboratory research, may also help to delay the growth of cancer cells as well as to reduce inflammation. Because they're low in calories, they're a great way to supplement your diet with vitamin C, E, and fiber. These are also quite tasty. Number 6. Carrots. A major antioxidant found in carrots is beta-carotene. It is converted by your body into vitamin A, which is necessary for your health and well-being. Zeaxanthin and lutein are also found in carrots. A diet high in antioxidants may help lower your risk of developing cancer by avoiding harm to your body's healthy cells from accumulating. With their low calorie and high fiber content, carrots can also add in weight loss, if that is what you're looking for. The reason for this is because obesity is associated with a higher risk of heart disease, diabetes, and some malignancies. Number 5. Dry beans. Tofu is a great source of plant protein and minerals. It's also a good source of B-complex vitamins and vitamin K. Dry beans such as navy beans, kidney beans, pinto beans, and black beans are other good sources of plant protein and minerals. Also high in fiber, they contain polyphenols, which act as antioxidants, and they are low in calories. As a result of their high protein content, beans are ideal for creating meatless meals that everyone will enjoy, even if they aren't vegetarians themselves. The use of dry beans may help to reduce the risk of heart disease, diabetes, and high blood pressure, according to research. They also have the added benefit of reducing swelling. Number 4. Kale. A good source of vitamin A, C, and K is kale, which comes from the cabbage family. Moreover, it's a good source of vitamin C as well as calcium, iron, magnesium, and potassium. Dietary salt and calorie intake are low in kale. Kale also provides a small amount of fiber, which is a nice bonus. The leafy green vegetable is high in antioxidants, which may aid to reduce cancer risk. It also contains the antioxidant lutein and zeaxanthin, which may help to reduce your chance of developing cataracts and macular degeneration in the future, respectively. As an added benefit to consumers, lutein may help prevent atherosclerosis, which is the accumulation of hard plaque in the arteries. Add kale to a salad or nibble on kale chips as a healthy alternative to potato chips or tortilla chips. A salad a day is a good goal to set if you want to improve your nutrition. Choose dark leafy greens such as kale, spinach, and collards, which are high in nutrients such as lutein, folate, and vitamin K, all of which help to reduce inflammation by slowing the simmering process. It is for this reason that a study published in the journal Neurology in 2018 discovered that consuming just one serving of greens per day was connected with a slower rate of cognitive loss in elderly people. According to research, each type of green has its own anti-inflammatory characteristics, so make sure a variety of them are in your diet to reap the greatest number of health benefits. Number 3. Olive oil. In the Mediterranean diet, olive oil is a staple, and it's been linked to heart health and a longer lifespan. It contains a high concentration of monounsaturated fats, which are beneficial to your cardiovascular system. Additionally, it contains polyphenols, which serve to protect the cells in your body from damage and degradation. Anti-inflammatory effects of olive oil. It decreases cholesterol levels, and polyphenols may be beneficial in the prevention of certain malignancies, according to research. It's a fantastic oil to use in your cooking. When cooking, it's not always an ideal choice, but it's excellent for salad dressings and completing vegetables as side dishes. Number 2. Oranges. Especially high in vitamin C and potassium, oranges are a fantastic snack food. Besides that, they are high in fiber, calcium, and folate. Because oranges are high in fiber and folate, they may be beneficial for your cardiovascular health. Vitamin C is critical for the proper functioning of the immunity system. Moreover, it helps to maintain the health of blood vessels by strengthening connective tissue. Including oranges and orange juice in your diet is a great way to combat inflammation. No, you don't have to preserve them in the morning. Aside from being a delicious snack, oranges may be used in a variety of cuisines and salads. Number 1. Salmon. In fact, salmon has the highest concentration of omega-3 fatty acids out of any other fish or seafood. The consumption of more of these fatty acids may reduce the likelihood of suffering from dry eyes, according to recent research. Because the healthy fats help to minimize inflammation and keep cholesterol levels in line, it's also beneficial for the heart health. Consuming fatty fish such as salmon, sardines, and mackerel at least twice a week, according to the American Heart Association, can lower your risk of heart disease. In addition to being an excellent source of an antioxidant known as astaxanthin, salmon is also a superb provider of omega-3 fatty acids. Fish, such as sardines, salmon, and tuna, are high in omega-3 fatty acids and are therefore regarded to have anti-inflammatory properties. When middle-aged and senior women were asked to participate in a big study, they discovered that those who ate one or more servings of fish each week were 29% less likely to develop rheumatoid arthritis, which is caused by inflammation of joint tissue. If you dislike the taste of fish, you might want to consider taking fish oil supplements instead. A product with at least a 2-to-1 ratio of omega-3 fatty acids, EPA to DHA, is frequently suggested. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comments section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching.